MCC January update is live right now, bringing many additions to the MCC here. Halo Combat Evolved skulls being added, match composer changes, modern aiming added into the MCC playlist updates. Updates coming soon, being foreshadowed on this update as well. Stay tuned throughout the entire video to learn all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another gameplay commentary. Today we're giving you some news about the MCC January update that has just been released. If you're playing the MCC right now, you are currently playing the newest version that was just released. Now, this update was originally slated to come out in December, but there was a bug that was noticed through the flight programming that they still do for the MCC, and it was pushed till after the UGC event, which recently happened, which I will be covering on this channel as well. This update brought plenty of new additions, a new facelift to the UI of the game, as well as modern aiming. The biggest thing I was looking forward to the addition of this update, so let's get all into the details here. So back in October, if you guys remember, that the MCC got a bit of a facelift update where there was flood infected. It was green, it was gross looking, but it looked really freaking cool. Well, now if you load into the MCC, you'll be seeing a brand new splash screen with a brand new background as well, kind of more winter chilled themed. And the reason why I bring this up is because of all the players that played in the flood playlist and earned the flood nameplate. November 19th to the 30th, there was the infection playlist, if you guys remember, and if enough people played it, we got something changing in the game at the end of it. Well, basically this is what it was. It was the winter update when it comes to these different kind of artistic envisions of the MCC UI. 343 goes into some statistics here saying that over 50,000 people played on the flood playlist, which is pretty cool to know that people are this much interested into playing campaign playlists, which is, I think, is one of the cool additions to the MCC that's highly underutilized. If you guys remember back in the December update, they were mentioning about people who played in the Insider program for the 12 matches for the testing of flight of this patch. We're going to get the ugly sweater nameplate. Now, we weren't able to get it in December because I had to push back this update, but now if you played your 12 matches at least during the Insider play session back in December, you will have that ugly sweater nameplate, which does look pretty fun. But if you missed that play session, don't worry, you're not gonna feel left out for too long. And the state here says you can earn the ugly sweater nameplate. Anyone who played at least 12 complete matches during December will be granted the nameplate later this month. And everyone who plays at least 12 complete matches in January will receive the nameplate in early February. So get out there and have some fun. So yeah, another example of 343 having something that's exclusive that's kind of fun, and then kind of just taking away the exclusivity of it. And so then everyone will be able to have it, but I don't think not many people will be rocking this nameplate because it's more of a Christmas thing, and obviously since the holiday has passed, having a ugly sweater is not necessarily like the coolest thing or most festive thing at the time, so it's kind of whatever. It's just a nameplate anyways. Next we have the new skulls being added to the CE campaign here. So we have a bunch of new skulls. We have the Anger, the Bandana, Catch, Ghost, Sputnik, That's Just Wrong, Thunderstorm, and Tough Luck all being added. If you want to learn what each one of these skulls do, please read in the description down below. I don't want to bore you with all the details because this is the TLDR. Or you can just click on the link in the description as well to the full update to understand everything. We also have match composer changes as well as a playlist update coming for the MCC just now. We have now added in, we have Super Duper Fiesta. That's really what it's called. And essentially it's Super Fiesta, but in the MCC, which makes sense since Super Fiesta has always been one of the most popular, if not the most popular playlist in Halo 5. Makes sense to bring it over to the MCC here. Now it is replacing Team Action Sack, but they do mention to not worry because Team Action Sack is going to be currently under a refresh and will be back soon. Super Duper Fiesta will be taking place in Halo 2 Classic, Halo 3, Halo 4, and Halo 2 Anniversary. Now for the match composer updates, like we mentioned earlier, that they removed Action Sack and replaced it with Super Duper Fiesta. 4v4 added to Super Duper Fiesta as well for game presets. 4v4, Halo 2, Halo 2 Anniversary, Halo 3, Halo 4 added to Super Duper Fiesta entries. 8v8, Halo 3, Halo 4, moved big team battle heavy entries from Action Sack to Slayer at low weighting. 8v8 Halo 4 moved Dominion entries from Action Sack to King of the Hill. And sadly, with the recent addition of the Halo 3 4v4 hardcore playlist, they've noticed that the Halo 3 doubles playlist has been pretty much decimated in population, and they're going to be removing it because of lack of population. Understandable. And there were some various bug fixes, some bugs that they have noticed as well at 343 about the MCC. They're all kind of minor stuff, nothing too game breaking. If you want to learn more about it, please check out the link in the description for the full post here. But I'm, like I said, giving you a TLDR. But we're looking ahead at what's coming next in the future updates of the MCC. One feature they're looking to add into the MCC is IP masking, which is apparently there's been a big of an issue when it comes to the, I'm sure, the higher end tier gameplay, that a lot of times people have been able to find people's IP addresses and basically kick them out of a server, which is kind of a ridiculous thing that have happened in the game, obviously. So they're going to be looking into IP masking, so then you don't have your jerks who just don't want to lose their 50 in whatever playlist they're in, and they're so desperate to keep that number that they're willing to hack into like servers and boot people out of it. Well, hopefully IP masking will be able to solve that. Next on the list is going to be that custom games browser. Yes, they're still looking into putting this into the game. It's been a while, but you know, obviously we've had some more fundamental changes to the game that help it function better, and I think what you need to do is make it function properly before you start adding in features that make it add in different kind of content, if that's what makes sense. And also the post-game Carnage Report is going to be getting some updates as well, so hopefully a little bit easier to read, give you all the information that you want to look at. And lastly, the part you're probably all most curious about, modern aiming. The biggest part of this patch, and how is it going to be implemented into the MCC? How does it really change up your aiming style in this game? Because a lot of people said that aiming in these classic Halos feels pretty loose and weird. Well, in this post, they do mention why, and they've giving you an easy fix of how to change that. Essentially, what the issue was is that the aim acceleration didn't really compute too well on in between X and Y axis, so diagonal movements weren't registering quite well and being kind of hard to track, and the aim acceleration was really weird at those points. And so then what they decided to do is give you the inputs of Halo 2 Anniversary and Halo 4, that same engine right there, and apply it to all the games. And I'm going to show you right now why that's so important. Okay guys, I jumped into some Halo 3 here to show you how modern aiming really affects aiming. I think Halo 3 does it the best, because I feel like this is the one where it feels the weirdest when it comes to aiming. One thing we're going to do, like I mentioned here, that in the post that they said that the XY axis was a little different, going diagonally was where the aim acceleration was really getting a little weird. So this is what it looks like without modern aiming. I'm going to try to follow this path right here of this border of this building, so you can kind of see, like, kind of like, it's kind of hard to follow, it's kind of hard to keep track really. Now if I go to settings, scroll down to the aim control over here, just under where your sensitivities are, put it to modern. That's all you gotta do is a quick change like that, and then you can look how much easier it is to path your way up and down this way, this edge right here, compared to, again, back to the classic aim. We're trying to go to the same speed. It was, like, you see how my cursor is kind of like, it's kind of zigzagging up this path. Like, I'm trying my best to really keep on it, but I have to really slow down. And you can see, like, how the aim acceleration really kind of like takes over after some time. And so you can see, again, like, we can look at these lights right here. I'm going to try to do this with modern aiming off. And I'm going to try to just kind of snap to these right here. And it's a little, like, I see I'm overshooting a little bit. Like, that one's all right. But you can see, like, right here, I'm seeing them. But, like, it's just like, it's kind of tough to keep my aim on these things. And where I think I should be moving my stick is not really correlating properly. But I'll go to modern aim here. You can see I'm going to try to snap to these things and how much easier that is. Look at that. Night and day difference right there when it comes to being able to snap between your targets, and it just feels so much smoother moving diagonally on your stick. So if you're going to be playing MCC, you're going to be wanting using modern aiming. Well, there you go guys, that's the entire update for January here. I might break this down into some other videos to kind of give you more details on this update, because there's a lot of information. I don't want to overwhelm you guys, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to see some more content like this, make sure to tap that like button. It greatly helps out the channel. It's been doing ways to see some more content like this. Leave a comment down below what your guys' experience with this new update. I do read all the comments and try to reply to most of them as well. If you're new to the channel, want to stay up to date with anything Halo related, make sure to tap subscribe with the bell, keep you notified we do anything on the channel. If you missed any content from me, or if you're new to the channel as well, make sure to check out the videos on the screen right over here. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.